The Core is the concluding part of the Demon Cycle series by Peter V. Brett, a series that I feel has not lived up to the potential first glimpsed in its opening chapter, The Warded Man. The Warded Man instantly became one of my favourite fantasy books when I first read it a couple of years back. It introduced me to a world of constant danger, a world where humans cowered behind meagre protection in the night for fear of the monsters outside their doors. The venture outside in the nighttime was as good as a death sentence for these people. Their world was terrifying, and every step they took within it was a risk. The story was always fraught with danger, and it kept my eyes glued to the page as I raced towards the end. As the series went on, the threat within the world became muted, and the demons became no more than a nuisance. The humans discovered powerful fighting wards, and these wards turned even frail old men into Conan the Barbarian. Suddenly, everyone was going toe-to-toe with demons they were afraid to even look at in Book 1. The sense of danger evaporated, and the overall story began to lose its teeth as it degenerated into another run-of-the-mill fantasy. I found the final chapter to be the weakest of the five parts. It often read like there was a book missing, as many of the subplots didn't seem to go anywhere at all, despite taking up a lot of ink. Prominent characters of the past, like Wanda and Garrod, were reduced to people who stood in the background and mumbled something about protecting Leisha every now and then, just to remind you that they are there. Most of the interest is with the main character's journey down to the core, something that has been worked towards for quite some time. Yet those chapters are not as common as you would like, and we'd said get many chapters of people having meetings and bickering about local politics, a subject that doesn't seem to have much relevance in the face of a potential extinction event. There's also much written about different characters being pregnant and having babies, but none of the resulting babies have much of a bearing on anything that happens. It felt like Peter V. Brett was using time here to set up another series before he'd even finished this one, and I think this book suffered a lot because of it. Overall, it felt very rushed, but it was still an easy read, and still better than a lot of the fantasy that hits the new shelf these days. I guess I'm just disappointed because I felt it was a series with a huge amount of potential, and now I just view it as a decent time passer that's good for killing a few hours on a plane journey. I give this one 3 stars.